Talk about the book. So when they go to the bookstore, they'll want to buy it. Okay, what do you talk about in the book exactly?
Okay, so first, it's very unusual because it's not centered around either holidays or specific meals.
Yeah.
It's centered around culture, travel, and menus in those cuisines.
Okay.
So each chapter is a destination, is an experience with a personal travel story.
Okay.
There's even a country there, Morocco, I've never been to, but I've always loved it. I've always dreamed about it. So I talk about my fascination and how I learned about it through, you know, in Paris, there's lots of Moroccan restaurants.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's really a very personal journey. And each recipe has also a story.
Yeah.
And then so each chapter has your menu, the table settings, the wine pairing, and then all the recipes that go with it.
So the wine pairing's quite interesting because people who might be watching may think, oh gosh, if I do this food and wine pair, I'd have to have a big budget.
No. So, okay, first of all, please don't be afraid because there's nothing fancy in the ingredients here.
Okay.
And this is why I really look to other cultures because that's where you get the flavor, the spices, the different herbs, you know. Vietnamese food, we have all the ingredients available here. It's just new ways of doing it, right?
Okay.
So there's no truffle oil. There's, you know, and maybe the most expensive thing here would be the cheeses, like brie or whatever, or salmon. You know, I think everything else is fairly affordable and can you can go in even a palenque, right? The wine, what I did was, rather than pairing each dish with wine, I paired the menu with wine.
Okay.
Because you're not gonna do a dinner like in a restaurant with a tasting, right? You have one dish, one wine, another dish, another wine, right? So the idea was, these are more or less the flavors that you'll be having during that menu, and these are the wines that could pair interchangeably with all those flavors.
So actually in your book you don't talk about the brand of the wine or what vineyard it's from, but you suggest
regions. I suggest for example varietals, you know, a Côte de Provence or a New Zealand Sauvignon Blanc, you know, something like that. And I also provide wine guides in the back.
Okay.
So to help you, this happened to me also, you go into a store, what am I gonna get? And then this is like, how will you organize your thoughts so that when you go there you're prepared, like, okay, I'm having this kind of menu, I'm having this many people, and this is more or less the kind of wine I should get.
Actually it's quite interesting because you can get a decent bottle of wine for actually 500 pesos or $10.
Correct.
You can drink that every day. I mean,
yes.
If you can't afford, you know, the
it's
grand
crew. It's just knowing where.
Exactly.
Right? Even my husband and I, we don't drink fancy wine every day.
Yeah.
How can I afford, you know, diapers and tuition? That costs money. I can't be drinking it away, right? So, you know, like, we always look for a good value for money. The wonderful price point is between 400 to 1,000, depending on the occasion. And that's all across the board. I noticed.
Okay.
Yeah.
I wanted to, I know, we're going to.